Hey guys, it's been a while since I've been on video, and I just wanted to say thanks for your patience. This video is going to vlog our progress on the bottom end build of the small block Chevrolet 406. We have got the crank installed, did some quick measuring on clearances with the crank. We got number one piston put in, got the cam put in, and did the degreeing of the cam to verify all that all is good. And all is good there, so hope you enjoy the video. Just some more quick details on this build. This is a Callies Magnum XL crankshaft. It is a small block Chevrolet 350 main standard rod journal crank with a big block snout. Because we're running the 871 blower with the significant amount of force on the crankshaft, on the snout of the crank, we are also running the blower shop big block Chevrolet dual keyway crank hub. So we are not running a harmonic balancer on this build. The big blower pulley and belt will serve that function. In addition to that, the crank is 375 stroke, 4155 piston. So nothing crazy about the stroke and everything on this. We are running the Callies Ultra I Beam connecting rods, 6-inch connecting rods, full floating pins, in addition to the Callies crank. We will never skimp on the bottom end, especially for a motor where we're going to be running a roots blower on it. So we've had to take our time and put a lot of effort in the bottom end, and we're excited. So just a few more details on the bottom end.
Yeah, the pin fits good.
All right. Look at that.
Feels easy.
Yeah.
Feels easy. Now, 45 is final. You want to do 20, 25, and then 45? I don't want to go too heavy on these.
I'll go 20.
25, or?
Yeah, I should. 25.
And then 45.
Yeah.
As you can see here, guys, we got the cam installed. We're dot to dot, and we are installing the crank gear with no advance. This cam came from Bullet with 4 degrees ground in, and now we're gonna go through and degree it and make sure it's where we want it based on the cam card. Thanks, guys. Oh, real quick, I'm gonna degree the cam and check the cam timing numbers at 50 thousandths lift. This cam came from Bullet with 50,000 timing numbers. Not all cam manufacturers provide that, but Bullet Cams does provide those numbers to you, and we're going to see how it degrees in.
It's all in this kit.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wow.
Another quick item to note is the number one piston is installed, and hopefully everyone understands that these type of pistons are dependent on which cylinder they go in. Of course, this is the number one piston, as you can tell from the valve reliefs, exhaust being towards the front of the motor, and then intake being positioned next to number three cylinder. Those are critical facts on these pistons for sure. Go around to see if we're at 30 on the other side. We are right there at it. Yep. All right, that's a light 30. For mine, that's right on 30. Let's go see what we got. Darn that, yes. That's about as zero as it gets right there, in my opinion. I want to get on the base of the cam. I want to go this way. We on the base of the cam right there, all the way through there. Now what I want to do is I'm going to zero this. Intake opens at 20 and a half at 50. We were at 21. So if I back that up just a hair,
21. I ain't worried about no half a degree. Now I'm gonna go around to the other side.
Closed 60 and a half.
All right, so we got 21 for 20 and a half, 61 for 60 and a half.
Like I said earlier, this cam is from Bullet Cams, but I work with Steve Morris Engines to design this cam, so I will share more of the specs later. But I will tell you that, as in this video you will see, we were degreeing the cam, and you will hear that the intake at 50 and intake closing and opening at 50. So you can calculate the duration of the intake lobe. It's not rocket science. And but other parts of the cam are pretty specific to this build, so I'm going to keep the specs to myself for now. If you have any questions, send me a message. One quick note on the timing cover we're using on this build. We're using a CVR two-piece bulletproof timing cover. I have never ran one of these covers, so this would be my first attempt at it. But it is a nice looking cover. It is two pieces. This piece mounts to the front of the block. It has a very nice O-ring that wraps around and seals it. It also comes with a roller cam button that will be installed in here. This bolt is in the way, but it comes with a roller cam button, and it comes with some shims where you can shim the cam button. And then of course we still run the cam bolt locking plate. We're old school. We like to make sure there's a physical restraint keeping that cam bolt from backing out. But wanted to show you guys the CVR cam timing chain cover that we're going to be running. Just for information purposes, this is a closed full billet timing cover set for a small block Chevrolet with a big block snout crank. Hey guys, here's a quick view of the 871 blower intake from the blower shop that will be going on this build. Right now we got it sitting on a different block and set of heads, of course, same geometry and everything that our motor will have. We've also got the first vent attached to the valve cover for our puke tank. Both valve covers will have a dedicated line hose back to the puke tank, and this puke tank is right here. This puke tank will sit in the back of the 48 Ford so that if we ever do dump a bunch of oil in it into enough to where those baffles will spray oil, those baffles are not going to be in the front of our car like most guys have their breather tanks mounted in the front and on both sides. And guys, those breather tanks are so small, they will get wet with oil, and those filters will spray oil out of them. And if you got those mounted in the front of your car, your slicks are going to run through that oil if you put any oil out of there. So our puke tank will be mounted in the back of the car and in the center of the car, so that if we do spray any oil out of that, I'm not running through it, so I don't endanger myself or endanger the racer we're racing against. We don't have these torqued down yet, but you can see we got everything is moving well. Nothing's in a bind there. The motor turns over extremely nice. And of course, you know, we've only got one piston in it right now, but everything just feels so smooth on this motor. And looking forward to getting the rest of the bottom end built here soon.